Welcome to Gourmet Mayank. We are in Varanasi. Varanasi lies in Bhojpur region of India, and in Bhojpur there is a language which is spoken. It's called Bhojpuri. Now some part of Bhojpur lies in the UP state and some part of the Bhojpur lies in Bihar state. But Bhojpur has its own culture, its own cuisine, its own aura, and that's what we'll be exploring in this food tour. We'll explore authentic Banarasi cuisine here. So we have three things in our mind. Let's see what else this food tour has in place for us, but specifically three things. So one is Baati Chokha, Litti Chokha, which is very traditional to Bhojpur region, and there is a place by the same name itself, Baati Chokha. We'll be going there. Then secondly, we have a beautiful property in Nadesar Palace called Taj Ganges. Now Taj Ganges has a very traditional cultural immersion program called Flavors of Banaras, where they serve you what's being cooked in the kitchens of Banaras, not like the commercial kitchens of Banaras, but what's cooked inside homes of Banaras. So they serve you with that cuisine. And then we'll be exploring the chaat culture here. So chaat culture is believed that primarily emanated from this place itself. Chaat is kind of a fast food, Indian fast food, where people like to have it. It's not a full meal, it's like a kind of a snack which people try, have it in the evening time. Very famous Kashi chaat bhandar, we'll be visiting there, and very unique chaats they have. One of the uniqueness of their chaat is the tomato chaat or tomato chaat. So we'll be exploring that place. We are at Namo Ghat. It's a very recently clean, developed ghat by the government. And you can see the hands of Mahadev or Lord Shiva behind me. Very beautiful sculpture there. The bridge behind me, if you see, is an old, hundreds of years old bridge. It was constructed during the time of Britishers. And it's constructed over this beautiful river, the Ganges. Let's see what all Kashi have for us in this tour. Varanasi, Banarasi or Banaras, whatever you call it. In the old Hindu scriptures, it's called Kashi. And this place where I've come now to have chaat derives its name from the same old scripture place. It's called Kashi Chaat Bhandar. Now this place is very old and it offers traditional chaat options which one can find as this Bhojpur belt. So we'll go to this place and explore these chaat options. It's located near Dashwamedh Ghat. So when you are visiting the river Ganges and you are visiting Dashwamedh Ghat, which is very famous, you can definitely visit this place. It usually opens in the evening time, because chaat people eat in the evening time. It's not much of a morning place. So let's go and check out what all options are there here. flavored tomato chaat. Now this is very special to this place. It's very authentic in this place. It has got some kind of oil running over it. Let me show you. Let me try to break it and show you what are the constituents of it. So this, these are the ingredients in it. It's basically made out of tomato paste and normal chaat ingredients are there inside this. So that's why it's called tomato chaat or tomato chaat. Little like crushed to the core. So I'll be tasting it now. You know, people like chaat because of some chatpata flavor, or you call it, I don't want to call it tangy because I want to call this chaat as tangy, because very sweet and sour flavor, that's chatpata in North India, and you add tanginess to it, that's tomato chaat for you. Very tasty, very authentic, very original to Kashi or Varanasi or Banaras. So the crowd has reduced to half from the time I came here. It's like still super crowded. The dustbin is overflowing. No time for them to clean the dustbin because they are anyway super busy handling the crowd. Let's move to our next destination after this. So, very traditional to Bhojpur region is the Baati Chokha or Litti Chokha. In Bhojpur region, it's Baati is known by the names as Baati. In Bihar, it's called as Litti. We'll be also in Purvanchal area, which is primarily the eastern part of UP area, it's called Baati. The recipe is very similar, the sizes might differ. Litti is a little smaller version of Baati. Baati is more of a spherical kind of ball, whereas Litti is more of a flat version of the same ball. It's like a flattened ball. Both have a filling of sattu in it. Sattu is gram flour. And sattu is not just like raw gram flour, it's cooked and mixed with spices, different spices. So let's go and explore this. They have made this kind of a cultural center where not just food, you can see handloom sari weaving also there, and they have displayed it with pride. So for example, this, if you see, it's a handloom sari weaving unit, very traditional, very old Banarasi sari which was quite famous in the Indian subcontinent. Here they have displayed the cold press oil machine and how it's currently run by electric motor, but they have mentioned it that earlier it was run by mechanical power. So this is the flour mill in which the sattu flour or the gram flour is taken out, and it's not fake, it's not just for showcasing purpose, it's original, they actually make it here. This is haldi making machinery. So in this they make haldi, which is used again in the food items. When I said that they have invested a lot in the experience part, I didn't mean just for the sake of this video. It is like a complete cultural center that too thronged by people because of its affordability. This place will definitely delight you. So if you are like looking for an authentic Banarasi experience or a Bhojpuri experience, this is the place. And they have not just curated their food, they have displayed the cooking of it. They have made the entire interiors look very original, very authentic, very traditional. It's like you are entering an old Kashi village home, and that's where you get this Kashi feel. So I am now getting inside. This is the door. I'll get inside and then I'll see how do they serve. And of course it will be Baati Chokha, but you must have got a feel by now that they don't just invest in the food or the taste of it, they also invest in experience. They have invested in experience and I want to have that experience. So let's go inside. So this is the plate. It's actually a wooden plate. They put this woven leaf plate over it. ये क्या क्या है एक बार बता दीजिए.
ये फरा है.
फरा.
ये दाल की पकौड़ी, ये पनीर
पापड़ पकौड़ा है.
ओके, ये पनीर पापड़
पकौड़ा. ये रूरल स्नैक्स आइटम है. ओके, जो हमारे सिवा किसी दूसरे रेस्टोरेंट में नहीं पकौड़ा जाता. अच्छा, ओके. ये चोखा है. सो हियर कम्स द चोखा. इट्स बर्न्ड इन कोल. And the sattu inside cooks. Look at the coal dust. And it's made in a very traditional way where opale are burnt. So it's not actually coal. Ek baati nikal ke dikhaiye. So we are taking this out. So this is baati. Now they remove the dust and then serve it with chokha. So this is the spherical ball which we eat, and this is the uple, the cowden cakes in which it's cooked, and that gives it its own smokiness, the smoke flavor. And finally comes our baati with dal. ये सत्तू बाटी है, पनीर बाटी है. सो दिस इज द कंप्लीट मील व्हिच दे ऑफर. एंड दे ऑफर दिस घी ओवर दाल आल्सो एंड ओवर बाटी आल्सो. वाओ, दिस इज घी. And that completes the meal. Let's start with paneer pakoda first. You have it this with this green chutney. It is so soft. Look at the softness of paneer. Next, we are gonna try this rice flour made snack. I have broken this into half, and I am trying this with this garlic salad. Now finally its time has come that we break this baati. I know you are waiting for this, and it's not easy to break it. So let's try start with the sattu baati. Oh, that's the original one. And we'll go to the paneer baati also. So this is sattu baati, full of sattu and spices inside it.
and made inside, you can call it a traditional one, in which cow dung cakes are used to actually make it. It's buried inside cow dung cakes. So this is the right method which the manager Chaudhary ji told us. Firstly, open this sattu, this bati, fill it with the garlic chutney, this, then the green chutney, this, then have a bite of it, and then have a spoon of dal bati. And he's saying that, which I experienced also, your mouth bursts with flavors when you eat like this. So this is like the cocktail which Chaudhary ji has suggested. बहुत अच्छा लगा है. Now we are opening this paneer bati, cottage cheese bati. Their paneer is very good, as I showed you in the paneer pakoda. And now this bati. Wow. That's the right method. Although adding green chutney, adds spice to it. You can also have it with just dal. This is steaming hot rice, and they have served chokha with it, and you generally have it with dal. So we'll put some dal, some chokha, mix it. And you can have chaas when you are feeling some spices. Just have chaas with it. So this is the kheer. So Chaudhary ji just told me that this kheer is made of milk from gir cow. Again, a very traditional desi or Indian variety of cow. And if you see the brown color, it's because this kheer, the milk for this kheer is boiled for 3 hours, and then again takes another 1.5 hours to cool down. So that gives this kheer this distinct color and texture. So this is the thickness which can describe the beauty of this kheer. Very authentic. It has got dry fruits and it has got that taste. In Hindi you call it kada hua doodh. In English you can call it very over boiled milk, maybe. Not sure about the English word. So this is it from my visit of Bati Chokha, cultural immersion of Banaras, and not just food, but to experience their various other facets of Banarasi culture. You get to see handloom Banarasi sari, you get to see spice making, cold pressing, you get to see how people used to sit in their homes and eat. Then you get to see and you get to eat Banarasi food. So let's take a boat from this place and move on to our next place.
Dadra. So Banaras has various art forms. This was composed in Banaras Gharana, and it's a very famous rag called Dadra rag. So we have come to Taj Ganges, and they have a restaurant called Varuna Restaurant. Now, the unique thing about this restaurant is that they have some Banarasi cuisines, and they call it flavors of Banaras. Now, what is Banarasi cuisine? Primarily, Satvik cuisine defines Banarasi cuisine. So, Satvik is when you don't add onion and you don't add garlic. So, in Hindu culture, generally worshipping people or followers of Hindu religion generally prefer to eat Satvik food. And especially in some fasting months or month of Savan, month of rainy season months, people eat Satvik food. Now, what is Satvik food? Basically, the term actually explains the pure food. So Hindus consider food which is fresh, which is good for their immune system, which is free from any smell. So that's called Satvik food. That's why it's free from onion and garlic, because of the pungency of the smell. So now I have ordered a Satvik Thali or a Satvik Silver Thali, which is a signature dish of Varuna restaurant. In that silver thali, you know, it's not some chef who has prepared this thali. So Taj Ganges has a very unique outreach, as a kind of sustainable outreach, where they have approached women around Banaras who live in villages, who live in local households. They have included their recipes. Now, all these, actually, these women actually come on like alternate days, bring these dishes, and it's kept separate from other meat dishes and other onion garlic dishes, because when a person who's traditionally follows Hindu religion and prefers Satvik food, they don't even like the smell of some other food in their food, right? So it's very important to keep it separate from the meat cuisine, the cuisines which have meat, and the cuisines which have onion garlic in it. So this Satvik food is prepared by women of Banaras. What an initiative by Taj Ganges. I think it's incredible, it's beautiful, and we'll be soon exploring silver Satvik Thali. Why silver? You'll know. So I'm all set for Thali. And what I liked about this restaurant is that it's a resemblance of art of Banaras and the cuisines of Banaras. And that's what how they have tried to give you an experience, a cultural experience of Banaras. As a tourist, as an outsider, it's very difficult to actually roam around Banaras, because it has very narrow lanes. Some of those are very dirty also. The ghats are very dirty. It's very crowded. People are like flocking to the ghats every now and then. So how do you, and especially when there are summers or rainy season, it becomes much more worse. So how do you enjoy the beauty of Banaras? How will you know what it's like to be in the oldest city, in the oldest civilization of the world? So that's where you can come to Varuna restaurant. You know, if you want to have a fine dine experience, at the same time you want to enjoy local cuisines, authentic cuisine, then I think this is the best place.
Sir, this is the Nimona. This is very famous in the Uttar Pradesh and this Purvanchal area. And this is made by the green peas, sauteed with the cumin and the clarified butter. So this is alu methi, and it is very popular in Delhi as well. So this is the log gobi dahi wala, the very famous in our restaurant as well. And you can say this whole city. And that after that, this is the paneer butter masala. It is also in the combined because we are giving a small quantity this one. So that is that people can have easily, but it will never go waste. So that is our motto and reason. And this is the small dal tadka for you. And this is called banta kalonji. This has a kalonji spices on this. So this is sattu paratha and chokha on this side. Some green salad and the plain yogurt. This is the kesari rasmalai.
We'll start with Nimona. Nimona is made of three things. It has lentils in it, it has green peas in it, and it has potato in it. This is very traditional to Banaras, very authentic. And alu methi is quite common. Alu is potato, methi is fenugreek. Now this is quite common in North India. This is cauliflower. Again, this is very unique to Banaras, the way they have made this. Paneer I won't talk much about because paneer butter masala. Again, very common to North India, especially Punjabi food. Dal is also very common. Now this is Bhanta Kalonji. So this is stir-fried brinjal. It's again very local, very original to this region, Bhojpur region. So Banaras is actually, Banaras lies in Bhojpur. If you go by Indian states and Bihar, some parts of Bihar and some parts of UP, majorly eastern parts of UP comprise of Bhojpur. This is chokha, aloo chokha, potato chokha. So this you eat with sattu paratha. What is sattu paratha? So sattu paratha is nothing but a paratha stuffed flat bread which has sattu in it. Gram flour mixed with spices. So that's sattu paratha. It's again very common in Bhojpur region. Sattu in fact is eaten a lot in Bhojpur region. So this is like, you can say, a staple in Bhojpur region. This is of course rice. This is curd. They have like made the curd in this earthen pot. So it gives a very distinct flavor. In local language it's called kullad. And this is rasmalai, again very famous, very common in North India. Sattu paratha is delicious. Imagine wheat flour bread which has gram flour inside, and that gram flour has spices in it. That's sattu paratha for you. It's very famous in Bhojpur region. So they've called this stir-fried brinjal as kalonji. Although kalonji is a little different thing, it's a different vegetable. Maybe there's some history to this, but let's try this stir-fried brinjal or kalonji. This is very different from North Indian food. I really want to know what spices they are putting into this, because the main ingredients are the same. Nimona. Now I'm having this with Nimona. Well, Banaras people or Bhojpur people generally go crazy about this Nimona, and you don't find in all the seasons because green peas is generally a seasonal vegetable. And it cannot be made, I assume, it cannot be made by any green peas, just by using sweet green peas. Very nice. you know, when I have something which is very local to the place, like this dish, I've never had anywhere in the entire country, in India, I've never had Nimona. Which makes me very happy that I've tried something new. Other dishes are, the recipes are a little different, the spices are a little different, the way of cooking a little bit. But this thing, this is the first time I'm having anything like this. Mashed green peas and mashed potato and lentils. And in fact, it has chickpeas also inside. Awesome. Let's have sattu with dal. If you ask me what you like the most, you already know my answer, Nimona, because of its authentic appeal. And secondly, this stir-fried brinjal. Stir-fried in local spices. This is again, I've never had. What a taste it has. What a combination of condiments and spices in it. This I think you'll only find in Bhojpur region. I'm sure by now you must have got it why they call it silver thali. Well, because they serve it in a silverware. And it's the original silverware, mind you. They were quite skeptical in allowing a professional camera in the restaurant. I had to almost wait 1.5 hours just to do the shoot. Worth waiting, trust me. If you love spices, combination of various spices, and bring out another art form, which is food, in its own unique sense, then definitely you should try Bhojpuri food and definitely you should come to this place. Although you have sattu paratha with potato chokha, but I'm liking it more with other dishes. So this is original silverware. I've asked them to make all the dishes for go, but this I want to finish it here. So I can't resist it anymore. So this is Gourmet Man signing off from Varanasi. We had a great tour. We explored various authentic cuisines and we missed some of those. So we missed kachori breakfast. It's very traditional breakfast option in Varanasi. It's like puri, which you get in North India, but with a little stuffing, and it's served with aloo. We missed that, but definitely we'll try it next time when we visit next time. Then we missed some milk products, which are again very famous. Then which are very famous in Banaras, like rabdi. It's only people say only pure rabdi you get in Banaras. And finally we missed bhang. Now bhang is made of marijuana and it's not illegal here. There are proper bhang shops which serve, which give you bhang, which even make milkshake with all sorts of other ingredients, very tasty. And it's one of the oldest forms to get high. Even Lord Shiva also used to use that form to get high. So that's it. Maybe next time we can come and explore Varanasi and explore these food options. For now, bye bye.